chapter-wise list of all my videos is available at this point. For DVD, pen drive, please write an email to me. These videos, they do not require internet, they play offline, there is no problem of buffering. And please subscribe to my channel for regular updates. Thank you for your support once again. I shall cover the most basic concepts of roots, quadratic equations, and let us see how we solve quadratic equations, what are quadratic equations, what are roots. Let us have a look at all that. So first of all, let us consider from a very zero level. Suppose somebody has written an expression like this, x square is equal to 9. Now for what values of x is the left hand side equal to the right hand side? Let us try to make a guess of that. One value obviously that comes to our mind immediately is 3, because 3 square is 9. So we can say that the above equation, equation 1, is satisfied for x is equal to 3. We also say 3 is a root of equation 1. A root is any value that satisfies a given equation. So in this case, we say that x is equal to 3 satisfies the equation 1, and therefore 3 is a root of this equation. You can observe another thing. Minus 3 also is a root. We cannot ignore it, because minus 3 square is also 9. So we say that this equation has two roots, plus 3 and minus 3. In a short form, these two are together written as plus minus 3. Both the signs together written like this, they actually represent two numbers, plus 3 and minus 3. This is a short form. The above equation would be precisely solved like this. We would say x square is equal to 9, which implies x is equal to square root of 9. So wherever you write a square root, you should also immediately write plus minus with it, because whenever your square is removed and a square root is brought, then you should write plus and minus, because for plus also this will be the value, and for minus also this equation will be satisfied. And since we already know square root of 9 is 3, so we can write it as plus minus 3. So plus minus 3 are the two roots of this equation. Take another example so that you are always comfortable with the basic terminology. Let us take another example. Supposing somebody writes x square minus 5 is equal to 0. This equation can be solved by writing x square is equal to 0 plus 5, because we take 5 to the other side, which implies x square is equal to 5, which implies x is equal to, now we are removing square and a square root is coming in its place, so we will write it as plus minus 5. This plus minus 5, as I have already told you, represents two numbers. One is square root of 5 and the other is square root of minus 5, minus square root of 5. So two roots of this equation are plus square root of 5 and minus square root of 5. These can be written in a simplified, in a shortcut form as plus minus square root of 5. Take another example. If somebody says x square minus 16 is equal to 0, which implies x square is equal to 0 plus 16 is equal to 16, and which implies x is equal to plus minus 4. Many people, they tend to ignore the minus sign and they would simply see x square is equal to 16 and they would write x is equal to 4. This is not wrong, but it is only partially right. The other half you have to write as minus also, because for plus 4 and minus 4, both the values, this equation is satisfied. So make it a permanent habit. Whenever you replace bring a square root, you should always bring as plus minus. This should be your habit. I have purposely taken three examples so that I am able to stress the importance of this plus and minus, which many people forget. So let us now proceed to our next part of this lecture. The next thing is quadratic expression. Quadratic expression to equation. Quadratic expression is any expression of degree 2. For example, we can write x square plus 16. This is an expression of degree 2. It is of degree 2 because the highest power of x that we encounter in this is plus 2. Therefore, this is an example of a quadratic expression. Take another example, x cube plus x square plus 5. This is not a quadratic expression because the degree of this is not 2, but it is 3. So this is not quadratic. We say this is not a quadratic expression. This is a quadratic expression because the degree is 2. Take another example. If somebody writes 6x square plus 3x plus 2, then this is also a quadratic expression because the degree is 2. When we write a quadratic expression like this as equal to 0, then it becomes a quadratic equation. Just putting equal to 0 will turn it into a quadratic equation. So if we have to turn this into a quadratic equation, we can write x square plus 16 equal to 0. So you can recognize an equation from the presence of this equal to sign. Whereas an expression doesn't have any equal to sign, it's simply a combination of terms. This is one term, this is another term, term, this is term. So a quadratic expression is a collection of terms, whereas a quadratic equation can be recognized by the presence of this equal to sign. There is one thing that is related to quadratic expression. This term is called zero. The zeros of a quadratic expression are those values for which the value of the quadratic expression becomes zero. Let us take an example. Supposing somebody writes x square minus 16. Now the zero of this quadratic equation is x equal to plus 4 and x equal to minus 4. This quadratic expression has two zeros, x as plus 4 and minus 4, because at both these values of x, this becomes 4 square minus 16, that is 16 minus 16 equal to 0. So a 0 is that value for x at which the entire value of the quadratic expression, it reduces to 0. Take another example. Supposing I write a quadratic expression like this. This is a quadratic expression because there is no equal to sign. Now zero of this quadratic expression, this expression So we'll say 1, 0 of this quadratic expression is x equal to 1 because 1 square minus 2 into 1 plus 1, it evaluates to 0. It equals 0. So we say that a quadratic expression has a 0 associated with it. A 0 is that value of x which causes the expression to finally add up to 0. So just like an expression has an association with the term called 0, let us see what is an equation associated with. Supposing the above quadratic expression is written in the form of an equation. Now when it is written in the form of an equation x square minus 2x plus 1 equal to 0, then we can obviously see that when x is equal to 1, the above equation is satisfied. The above equation is satisfied. So we say, instead of saying x is equal to 1 is a 0 of this equation, we say that x is equal to 1 is a root of the equation. Although the value of the 0 and root is one and the same, a 0 or root, they have exactly the same value. They are just two different ways of saying the same thing. But technically, an equation is said to have a root and an expression is said to have a 0. A root of a quadratic equation is that value of x at which the equation is satisfied. The 0 of an expression is that value of x at which the entire expression collapses to 0. So I hope you understand that an expression has a terminology associated with it as 0 and a root is associated with an equation. We say expression is synonymous to 0 or is analogous to 0. Equation is analogous to a root. So if somebody writes those questions on analogy like this, if equation is to root, then expression is to what? Then your option should be 0. Equation is to root, then expression is to 0. If you are fully understanding this concept, let us now move on to the more detailed discussion on quadratic equations. We will be concerned with quadratic equations for the remaining of the lectures now. I have written quadratic equations like this. 6x square plus 2x plus 3. I have written quadratic equations like this so far today. This x square has a coefficient 6, x has a coefficient 2, and this is the free or the constant term. A quadratic equation is usually written in a more general form like this. We say the most general form of a quadratic equation the most general form is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Where a is some constant, b is some constant, c is some constant. There is one restriction, that a should not be equal to 0. Because if a is 0, this equation will become bx plus c equal to 0, which is no longer a quadratic. So this is the most general form of a quadratic equation. So if we compare the above equation with this format, then we usually write a is equal to 6 because a and 6 are both the coefficients of x square. So we write that this equation put in a standard form will have a is equal to 6, b is equal to 2, and c is equal to 3. So we usually translate our numerically given equation to a standard form by writing the values of A, B and C. In all international universities everywhere, the terminology is AX square plus BX plus C, so this is a standard terminology. Let us translate a few more equations to standard form. Let us say another equation is 2x square plus x plus 5 equal to 0. In this case, we observe that a is 2, b is 1 and c is 5. We get these values by observing this 2 for ax square, this 1 for bx and this 5 for c. Take another example. Supposing this is written x square minus 2x equal to 0. This is also a quadratic equation because the degree is 2, but in this case let us see what are the values. A is 1, b is minus 2 in this case because b is attached to x, and c is 0 in this case because there is no constant term, so we'll write c equal to 0 in this case. Likewise, if we have a quadratic of this form x square minus 6 equal to 0, in that case a will be 1, b will be 0 because there is no middle term, and c will be equal to minus 16. Each quadratic equation has exactly two roots, neither less nor more. A quadratic equation cannot have one root, it cannot have three roots. It has exactly two roots. Now I won't go into derivation of these concepts. These are for your knowledge purposes that you should remember. So how do we express the roots of a quadratic equation? Supposing the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 with a not equal to 0, then mathematicians have actually used methods and expressed the roots of this equation in the form of a formula. That formula can be easily derived, but I will not go into that. You should look up the basic textbooks, but right now you should remember that formula. So I'll express that formula. The roots of this equation can be written according to this formula: minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So as you must be seeing, because of this plus minus, there are two roots of this quadratic equation. One is minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. The other is minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is also called quadratic formula. So you should try to remember this formula. Many times it comes handy, although we'll all try to see shortcut methods also. This formula is one of the most important formulas when it comes to solution of quadratic equations, and we can see that it shows two numbers as the solutions of this equation, as the roots of this equation, minus b plus 1 and minus b minus 1 and all that. Now I will make a further study of this formula to make some notes on the type of roots that a quadratic equation can exhibit. So let us take that. So we say that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 has two roots. Roots are minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac entire divided by 2a. This is what we have so far. Now the nature of the roots is totally dependent on this expression. This expression, I'll write it as discriminant equal to b square minus 4ac. Because everything else is a number, but this is a more rogue-like, a problematic story that looks in the whole quadratic expression that makes it look very complicated. This b square minus 4ac is called discriminant, or you can write it in the short form as capital D. If you do this, then the quadratic formula becomes plus minus square root of D divided by 2a. Now let us split this observation into cases. Case 1. If b square minus 4ac is positive, that is more than 0. If it is positive, then this square root can be evaluated. So we say roots exist. Roots exist only if b square minus 4ac is positive. Because if b square minus 4ac is negative, then you will have to write an expression like this, minus 7, square root of minus 7. It is not possible to find out the square root of a negative number when we are dealing with real numbers. So we say that roots do not exist if b square minus 4ac, if roots exist if b square minus 4ac is positive. Case 2. These cases will come quite handy when we solve our questions, because these are the core concepts. These will always help. Examiners will try to trap questions on these. Let us see what is case 2. If b square minus 4ac is 0, if it becomes 0 or evaluates to 0, then what will the roots be? In this case, this part will become 0 because square root of 0 is 0. So we would say the roots in this case would be minus b over 2a. Because this plus minus, as I'll show on the rough side, it will become something like this, b square plus minus 0 by 2a, which ultimately becomes minus b by 2a. This plus minus 0 will collapse to 0. Now you might think that this is collapsing to a single root. No. Scientist or mathematician always say that if b square minus 4ac is 0, this equation has two roots, but both the roots happen to be equal. So we say if b square minus 4ac is negative, the roots are equal. If b square minus 4ac is 0, the roots are equal. So let me summarize this in the form of a chart so that you can revise this also and you can have a summary form in front of you. So this is what the summary is. Discriminant. Discriminant D. If this discriminant is more than 0, then we say roots exist. This is guaranteed, and if it is equal to 0, roots exist and are equal, and if it is less than 0, roots are not real, but they are usually called complex. Complex numbers are more advanced numbers, we will not take those numbers. So we have practically three cases, d more than 0, d equal to 0, and d less than 0. So depending on this, you have various possibilities. Now if the roots exist, we have two more possibilities. D is a perfect square. D is a perfect square. So let me write that formula. Minus b plus minus square root of d by 2a. If d is a perfect square, what is a perfect square? 16 is a perfect square, 4 is a perfect square, the square root of which is a number. So the square root of this is 4, the square root of this is 2, but root of 5 is not a perfect number. because it doesn't evaluate to a complete number like 4, 2. So we see that if D is positive and it is a perfect square, then the roots are rational numbers. Rational numbers do not involve square root, that is without square root. Obviously, if D is a perfect square, this square root will cancel out and we'll be left with an entirely rational expression which doesn't have any square root. And if D is not a perfect square, then roots will be irrational. That is, they will involve a square root sign. So this is the complete chart which you can note down. I'll revise. If D is more than 0, roots exist. Further two possibilities: if D is a perfect square, roots are rational numbers without a square root. If their roots exist and D is not a perfect square, then the roots will be irrational, that is, they will involve a square root. On the other hand, if roots are D is exactly 0, the roots will exist and they will be equal, and if D is less than 0, roots will not exist, they will not be real, they will go into the complex domain, which is beyond the scope of our present lectures and syllabi. To sum this whole thing up, let me solve one numerical example with you, and that will be a complex example, so that you are having an understanding of this. We'll continue to refer to this chart throughout our lectures on quadratic equations. Let us try to now take a small example.